In this video, we're going to solve some basic trigonometric equations and we're going to solve for solutions in the interval from 0 to 360 using some basic techniques that you should be familiar with. So let's look, first of all, before we go into the methods here. There are several ways I mentioned in another video to define a trigonometric function. One way is to define it using an angle in standard position. So that's simply an angle whose initial size along the positive x-axis and the terminal side winds up in one of the other quadrants. It could be quadrant 1, 2, 3. It could be quadrantal angle, but this is the main focus right here. If we can locate a point on that terminal side, say xy, then we define the functions this way. The sine of theta would be y over r. And remember the sine and the cosecant are just reciprocals. So cosecant would just be r over y. Cosine of theta would be x over r. And the reciprocal of that is secant of theta. That would be r over x. Tangent of theta would be the y component over the x component. Cotangent is the reciprocal of that, x over y. So it's important to know the sine of the trig function. Obviously in quadrant 1, and remember the r value here is the distance from the origin to the point that we select. That's always positive. X and y could be positive or negative depending on the quadrant. Look at in quadrant 1, the x value is positive. We go to the right, and then we go up. So it's positive, positive. So all the trig functions that have a terminal side in that first quadrant, remember they could rotate several times and then wind up in quadrant 1. You still go by these signs. So the sine, the cosine, the tangent, and of course the reciprocals are all going to be positive. So the thing to be aware here also is that let's take the sine function as an example. So here I have an angle theta, and then this angle that I've named theta prime is the angle between the terminal side and the negative x-axis over here. It's important to know that the sine of the angle theta in standard position is always going to be the same as the sine of the reference angle, except for the sine. So here, depending on the quadrant this is in, this could be sine theta equals 2. This could be plus or minus. So in other words, let's say this angle is 135 degrees. And let's say the reference angle here is 45 degrees. If you put your calculator in degree mode, then you take the sine of 135. And let's first determine the sine of this, plus or minus. Well, this angle that I have here terminates in quadrant 2. And in quadrant 2, the x is negative by the y, but the y is positive. So I have a positive value, or the distance from the origin to that point is always positive. So this will be a positive number. So in this case, the sine of 135 will equal to plus the sine of 45 degrees. Now, again, it's going to depend on the quadrant. So let's suppose I go over here and make the angle. Let's say the reference angle now goes this way. Let's say that's 225. And this reference angle over here is going to be 45. But now look where the angle terminates. It terminates in quadrant 3. In quadrant 3, we go a negative this way and then negative down. It's negative. So in this case, again, the angle in standard position is 225. So if you take your calculator and compute the sine of 225 degrees, that should be the same as the sine of the reference angle. which is 45. But remember, the sine of any acute angle is always positive, but 225 is in quadrant 3, so this would have to be negative. So the sine of 225 will come out to the same as this. You can check that out in your calculator. So now let's go. That's the idea we're going to use in these. So let's say I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides here. I want to mention to you, know your 30-60 right triangles. Know your 45-45 right triangles. So you can recognize when you have a value like the square root of 3 over 2 or 2 over the square root of 3 on the right side. You know, in that case, your answer might be an exact answer. Or you get 1 over the square root of 2 or the square root of 2 over 2. Those kind of things. But in this case, see. This would be 2 This would be negative 1. So we divide through by 2. We get sine of theta is equal to negative 1/2. Dividing through by 2. Now you should recognize that as one of your standard values for the 30-60 right triangle. But if you don't, so check your mode. Make sure you're in degree mode, because you're dealing with degrees here. And we are. And then we just want to say then sine of theta is equal to negative 1/2. Then just take the inverse. So second sine of negative 1/2. So negative 1/2. Is equal to negative 30. So that means that theta is equal to negative 30 degrees. So remember, we want positive solutions. We want solutions in the integral, and the interval from 0 to 360. We get a negative 30. And I want to point out to you that if a trigonometric equation has one solution, it has an infinite number of solutions, because all you have to do is add the period of that function, 360, for the sine, cosine, secant, and cosecant. And for the cotangent and the tangent, it's 180 or pi. Here we're dealing with degrees. So what you can do here is just take 30 degrees as your reference angle. So here's what we'll do then. So we know we want to come up with a negative answer, because the sine is negative. So what we do is, okay, in what quadrant is the sine negative? Well, it's where the y value is negative, because it's y over r. So let me put 30 degrees. This is 30 degrees here. And this is 30 degrees there. So basically then, since we want positive angles and the two solutions we have, this one here, so that's going to be what? It's 180 and then plus 30 more, so that's going to be 210. Degrees. And then another possibility would be this angle right here, 30 degrees in that quadrant, or this angle over here goes this way, which would be 150, but there the sine is positive. Notice here we get sine of theta equal to a negative, so we want to get a negative result. So this angle right here then would be all the way around is 360, and then we subtract 30 to get to this angle here. So this should be 330. Degrees. And that's your solution. Now, if you did it, sometimes they'll give it to you in this way. They want the solutions in the interval from 0 to 360 degrees. Sometimes it'll be in radians from 0 to 2 pi. Theta will be greater than or equal to 0 radians, but less than 2 pi. if they did that, you could still work it out in degrees if you're more comfortable working with degrees, and then just convert these two radians by multiplying by pi over 180. In this case, you're going to get exact answers. So this would be, if they wanted the answer in radians, 7 pi over 6. And this would be 11 pi over 6. And all I did is multiply each one of those by pi over 180. And the degrees cancel out because I got 180 degrees in the denominator. Those degrees cancel and you just reduce it. You get 7 pi over 6, 11 pi over 6. Now, if they ask you for the complete solution, remember the solution is infinite. If you have one solution, you have infinite number of solutions. Just add a multiple of the period. So I could just add the complete solution would be 210 degrees plus k times 360. And this one would be plus k times 360, where k is any integer, negative or positive. So there you get all the solutions, the positive ones and the negative ones, and so on. But here we just want the ones between 0 and 360. So in this case, we have two solutions. Just like equations in algebra, quadratic equations where you can solve by using the quadratic formula, completing the square, or by factoring, well, you have the same thing in trigonometry. First, if you have a quadratic, there you have it, a quadratic in cosine theta. Try to factor it, and if it doesn't factor, then you can use the quadratic formula. The cosine theta would represent the x, and you take it from there. But in this case, I factor this out. 3 cosine squared will factor into 3 cosine theta. It should be cosine of theta. And since it's a plus here in the third term, both signs will be the same. This will be a minus, and this will be a minus. Then we just need factors of 3 that will work. I only have two factors. I can use 3 and 1. So let's try it out this way. 3 and a 1 here. So cosine theta times 3 cosine theta is 3 cosine squared theta. That checks. Minus 1, minus 3 times minus 1 is 3. For the middle term, multiply here, we have minus cosine theta, and over here we get minus 9 cosine theta. That adds up to minus 10, so that works. And now once you have it factored out, that means that I have a product of factors equal to 0. That means one or both factors have to be 0. So I just take each of these and set them equal to 0. So 3 cosine theta minus 1 can equal to 0, or cosine theta minus 3 can be 0. So then we this is just like it was 3x minus 1. This is just like x minus 3 equals 0. So we isolate the cosine theta in this case. So we add 1 to both sides. I get 3 cosine theta is equal to 1, 3, then I divide by 3. So I get cosine theta with equal to 1/3. And then on this one, again, add 3 to both sides, and I get cosine theta equal to 3. But we know from the graph of the cosine function that it isolates between negative 1 and 1. So the cosine of any angle is always between negative 1 and 1, never larger than 1, never less than negative 1. So this one's going to have no solution. So I just say, you can just say no solution for this one, or I write the empty set symbol here. No solution. Now for this one here, not going to have an exact solution for this one because I don't have an answer that gives me a radical 3 or the square root of 2 or something like that. So in this case, what I'll do is I take the cosine inverse of both sides. Let me just do this. Take cosine inverse out of the left side, and that just leaves me with theta. And on the right side, that'll give me cosine inverse, write it that way. I have 1/3. Okay. Then I'm ready to use the calculator. There goes second, and at the getting the cosine inverse, make sure it has a negative one there. That's what the inverse is, otherwise you're just taking the cosine of 1/3. Hit enter. So here I get a positive value, and the angle is less than 90 degrees. So this is my reference angle. So one answer is definitely going to be theta is equal to 70. I'm going to round this off to two places, 70.53 degrees. So that's one answer. So that means they say that go right there. And notice I get cosine equal to a positive. So I'm looking for a positive value for the cosine of the angle. So this is one possible answer. And of course, it's 70.53 degrees. And then the other possibility, okay, I could put the reference angle over here. This could be 70. And I could use this angle. But in quadrant two, the cosine is negative. Quadrant two, the cosine is negative. So I don't want that one. Then it has to be over here. So we're looking at this angle, where this is 70.53. Now we give the answer. Now which one is it going to be? Well, remember, it's going to go rotate counterclockwise. So it's going to come like this here. So the angle that I would want in standard position would be the 360 minus 70.53. And that should be 289.47. Okay. And if you take the cosine of those two angles, you're gonna get 1/3. Of course, you'll get it as a decimal. So let's check it out here. Well, let's check it out. Let's see. Cosine 70.53. I don't need degrees because the calculator is already set to degrees, so it knows that this is degrees. So if I calculate this, I get 0.3333. That's an approximation for 1/3. If you take 1 and divide it by 3, you'll get 0.3333 and so on. Remember, here I rounded it off. So the more decimal places I add or leave it with, the more accurate it's going to be. Let's try the second one. Cosine of 289.47. Hit enter. Again, same sort of thing. 0.3333, which is again 1/3. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.